you think of rock and roll girl power, look no further than Susie Quattro. The sassy performer has recorded a swag of hits during her incredible career over 5 decades. Have a look. You was January 2015.
Yes, for my final tour. it actually was.
What happened?
I had no idea this was going to happen. I, you know, it was the towel around the, you know, around the shoulders at the end, tears, the whole, and then I just sort of went. After a few months, I just went.
Eh. Did so, you miss it?
Totally. I never ever will say that again. That you'll never hear final out of my mouth again.
Okay.
Rock to rock till I drop.
It's the final time you'll say that.
That's the final time I'm saying that.
So more retirements than Johnny Farnham.
You know that.
It's only the first one.
That's right. I know. That's true. Good point, well made.
Who was that you were singing with for Stumbling In?
That was the lead singer from Smokey. He's got a good voice.
What's his name though?
Chris Norman.
Oh, right. Yeah. Fabulous.
Yeah. It was one of the evergreens.
Yeah.
That one and If You Can't Give Me Love were the two that were not my normal kind of thing. And they're real evergreens.
Yeah, they're fabulous.
Now, Susie, since you spoke to us last, and this fills me with sadness to say this, but you've actually become respectable, haven't you? You've become a doctor.
Excuse me, everybody. I am Dr. Quattro.
Dr. Quattro!
I got awarded, I got made an honorary doctor of music at Cambridge University, dressed in a cap and a gown, held it together until I stood up there to make my speech and saw all the dignitaries, and then I lost it. But then I got it back again. But what an honor. I didn't even graduate high school.
Oh,
that is fantastic.
Shows you what you can do.
It's awkward because I thought you'd become a medical doctor. I was going to say, I've got this spot, which I was wondering if you have.
Make an appointment.
you've also brought some friends with you this time. Tell us about QSP.
It was my husband's idea about 10 years ago. It took that long to happen. It's myself, Andy Scott, the original guitar player from Sweet.
Yeah.
And Don Powell, the original drummer from Slade. Right. There we are together. Mm. And we got together, we made an album. We started with covers, and then we started to write. And so when you start to write, then you put your stamp on it. Mm. Then my husband said, after the tour was already booked, why not have QSP be the opening act? Mm. So now I'm supporting myself.
That's great.
Which actually everybody should do.
Yes.
But it means I have to go out, do that, and then go back, change, and come back out and speak. So,
brilliant.
It's that's just a good thing I'm a Gemini.
I think your fans would probably love it, and you've got some of the most passionate fans of all.
I suppose they've been with you
forever.
I know. It's a real love affair. I always say, Australia and me, we have a love affair, and we should never actually get married.
Oh. Yeah, 32 visits.
Well, it's the best way to kill a romance, as they say, isn't it?
Yeah, there's a lot of jokes there, but I'm not going to go there. Okay.
I love you, darling.
You mentioned that you're a Gemini.
Yeah.
What I have found fascinating about you is that you're also psychic, too.
Yes, I have a very strong... We all have it.
Mm.
Who's kidding who? Especially women.
Mm.
We have a sixth sense that's uncanny.
Mm.
I just never close my areas off so I can sense things really a lot. I'm very sensitive. Yeah.
How do you do that in an audience, though, when you've got so much energy out there?
But that's fantastic.
Okay.
Because I can go out there to a cold audience, just people, you know, just walk out and I can feel it.
Mm.
And I'm a real people person.
Yeah.
I could probably tell you all about yourself within
tell
five
me.
Seconds. Okay. Well, you shouldn't have done it. Sorry.
Whoa, zip now, my lip.
Hang on a second. Look at her face. We need to talk more about Suzy Quatro's psychic abilities. So what do you mean about Jess?
Oh, I just,
Are you actually picking something up from her at the moment?
I just had a sense that you had done something recent that you shouldn't, that you have been deciding about for a long time. You shouldn't have done it.
Jess?
Oh, it's that cat painting. Yes?
Not that it's bad, but you should have taken a few more weeks to think about it. And I've seen the video.
Now listen.
No, it's all right. I'm only teasing.
I'm teasing.
Do you pick up on otherworldly spirits, or can you predict the future when it comes to your psychic?
I'm not a weirdo. Well, not completely. I'm just most artists. Yeah. Being an artist, you are just sensitive.
Yeah.
And you pick everything up, you know. Mm. I can't say it any other way. I've talked to other artists like myself, songwriters. You just pick everything up, that's all. You're just open. It's a pain. It's a pain sometimes.
Dead grandmothers talking to
No,
them.
I don't have dead grandmothers talking to me now. I sometimes get my mom in my head saying, you know, no. But that's normal.
Yeah.
Mm. Your mother goes, she never leaves you. She stays here.
Oh, yes, she does.
Oh, yeah, they tell she you does. Off, don't they?
Yeah. My mother,
you can hear them.
Yeah.
Yeah, but she's still alive, his mom.
I know.
She's still alive.
Oh, yeah.
I never forget, I took my, talking about mothers, I took my mom and dad to a show in Detroit, the first time I'd come back since having hits. So it was like a big deal. I had a limousine and everything. I was really proud. So we're coming back from the show in the limousine. And I said to my mom, makes me laugh still, how did you like the show? And she's in front. She went, well, Susan.
Oh.
She said, it was very nice, but did you have to stand with your legs so far apart? And I said, yes. because actually, it
feels
right. It feels right. What a great line.
And you were probably in leather.
Yes,
of course. At that time. How many leather suits have you got?
Oh, about... I've got a lot in my ego room that I've retired, but I have about five or six working ones.
Mm. Oh, right. Yeah. No one does it as well as you do.
I love that one.
That's my gold one.
Do you change them during a show? Do you get in and out of the leather suits during a show, or do you stay in one leather suit throughout the show?
It's not easy
in and out. Because that would be tricky, right? Yeah.
It's not easy.
Do you need baby powder or something?
Sticks to you and all that, you know, and it's you who, if my husband's with me, he unpeels me. And that's another story.
Speaking of which...
the only man sitting up here.
That's right. Now, you've said that you helped a lot of men get through puberty.
I did.
And I'm not psychic, but I think those jumpsuits might have been part of the reason. Have you ever thought of a Suzy Quatro museum, maybe in Detroit?
Oh. I've thought about that many times. I made a start on it with my ego room. Mm. You know, it's got absolutely everything up there. And it's become an analogy. You know, that you have to go up two flights of stairs and there's a heavy wooden door and you have to push it open. Then you go in and there's your ego. And then you come out and you shut the door. And that's how you stay. And I am pretty normal. That's how you stay normal in this profession.
Yeah, good.
You
on
have
you.
To separate. Yeah.
Mm. Listen, this is fabulous. This idea.
That's my box set. 82 tracks.
And
four CDs.
And the booklet.
Well,
it's not a booklet.
It's beautifully packaged.
Yeah, it's really good.
It's fabulous.
Suzy Quatro, you are cooler than ever. Susie's tour, it's called Leather Forever.
Oh, yes.
Rock your name. That'll be on our website. Suzy Quatro, everyone. Yay!